with Ms. Dr. Simonis for the Double Crossers in Black, and that's Jan Trainer, both skating under their real names. Josie Simonis is your lead jammer.
I'm not going to skip behind is Jan Trainer, but Josie will have some time to work here. No one has been box just yet. Blue all in the front. Black comes to attack as both jammers hit to the back. 2 points for the Crossers, 0 for the next half. And we're looking at Mia Dillon jamming for the Mannequin Nappers up against Yam Kapow for the Double Crossers.
Both these jammers sophomores, both in their second season, am I correct in that? Am I wrong about Yam Kapow?
I think so.
Could be wrong. So the assassin drew first blood in the first jam. Meanwhile, Mia Goham up near the front. She is your lead jammer. They were outside the engagement zone.
Daspa drags Yam Kapow all the way back. Yam trying to find the way around Daspa, Funkadelic, and Magic leading back. Meanwhile, Mia Goham is through with five. And Yam is still trying to find daylight through all that blue. Mia with some nice footwork there is almost free of the back, and she is through again. Laps Yam Kapow has 10 so far in this jam. However, Max Stylish to the box has a mannequin locker.
Mia Goham calls off the jam by tapping her hips. She scores three more, and three more for the Double Crossers as well. We're looking at 13-5 in favor of Lightning Bolt Mannequin Attackers.
Board jam for the Mannequin Attackers. Double Crossers are feeling clearly dangerous. Still got just under 28 minutes left in the first period of play. 13-5 in favor of the Mannequins. Josie and Cork going at it head to head. Work around the outside. She's the lead jammer of the Mannequin Attackers. Clearly dangerous. Out a few steps behind. Off the penalty box as Mannequin blocker Claudia Van Damme. Leaving only two Mannequin blockers as Morton enters. Close on the outside. Let's see that final score. Looks like 3 for the Crossers and all 4 for Mork and the Mannequin Attackers.
Now we get our first look at Zoe Trocius, the veteran jammer for the Mannequin Attackers, and rookie Sugar Rush for the Double Crossers.
Mannequin Attackers down 2 blockers to start. The Double Crossers starting with a full complement of blockers. Neither jammer quite able to yet make it through. Looks like lead jammer's going to Zoe Trocius.
She powered her way through there, Justice.
That big hit was able to clear her legally. You can't hit somebody right in the center of the chest. Right up the middle, Zoe Trocius steps right in the correct spot and gets through easily. Now off the box is Samantha Judge, and it's a power jam from Mannequin Attackers as Sugar Rush hits the box with the Black Star.
Zoe, the deceptive move. Another 5 points, racking up the points here early. The Mannequin Attackers taking the early
lead. Up the inside, and the Crossers just go off of that one and left the inside line open for Zoe, who currently has 15 points. As a power jam continues, goes to the outside. Another easy 5 for Zoe. 20-0 jam. Methamphetamine heads to the box at the end of that one. And there we go.
Right now, we're looking at Jan Trainer taking the line for the Mannequin Attackers. Still 2 players in the box for the Double Crossers. Sam Judge and Sugar Rush, the jammer. So it's definitely a power jam as Jan Trainer starts things off. And it's also down 1 blocker.
Jan Trainer going face to face with
Josie Simonis with Jan Trainer. She is your lead jammer. A very powerful jammer. Takes a shot. Has to come in behind those blockers that down her out. Dan Spunk playing some brutal defense, not letting Sugar Rush get through with the assist from Funkadelic and work and swing her back so far. Got that, but I mean, re-enters the frame, so full compliments on both sides.
Nice move by Trainor there to find the daylight around Simonis on the outside.
Not quite through yet.
However, looks like clearly Dangers have taken the star, but won't have enough time to score as Jan Trainor takes all five and calls that jam in.
8 points for the double crossers, and it looks like 46 for the Magic Attackers. Just over 24 minutes left in the half, and we're looking at Lena Bilham and Yamka Powell once again facing off in the jam line. Penalty box empty. The non-skating officials hate when I say that. The ball inevitably.
Bill in the blank, shaking his fist at us in anger. Mina put the lead on our second jam of the game. Now Kapow dealing with Bashima. Kelly Kontabali Gulita over there in the front of the back. Now Mia in the back working through Malicious, Iceberg, and Mary Poppin' Cats. Mia will call it off. She's got a ball. Looks like they're going to give her... Looks like three. So 3 points for Mia there. We're not able to get that last point on. I think Mary Poppin' Cats.
The penalty box remains empty. Josie Simonis and Bork taking one each other on at the jam on line. Collision. Bork takes Josie Simonis out of bounds.
And now it is what's turn to get recycled.
Jan Trainor with a nice hit on Josie Simonis to take her out of bounds. So much recycling in this jam. You gotta come in behind anyone that was in front of you if you get knocked out of bounds. Lead jammer is Bork. They cut the track penalty going to Josie Simonis. Got knocked out and that picked herself back up.
That was all Jan Trainor there with a very nice hit the very top of the pack and jumping back, staying on her feet through a hit from Vanessa Judge.
Bork, gonna score and pass. She gets on through. 5 points. Dev Spunk heading to the box with a backlock penalty. Jam is called off. No points that time around. And it looks like we've got Zoe Trocious up on the line for the Manic Attackers. While Ms. Dr. Josabelle Simona still standing in the box for the double crossers. So we'll head start here for the Manic Attackers on this jam.
So Jersey will coming out of the box in under 10 seconds, but how many seconds Zoe has to work with is unknown from our angle. Zoe makes it work.
Lead jammer going to Zoe Trocious. Jersey's one is out not too far behind her. Sneaks up on the back and finds a way through.
Looks like Zoe's going to keep it going to get Spunk out of the box here. So Josie equalizes. However, the Manics will probably end up with the pack advantage after the damage mentioned call. And it hooked up very nicely there. They get the 4 points they wanted from the pack previously, and they managed to get a crosser in the box. So it's winning 4-0 and having one block, they win 8-4 and end up with a different player.
Such quick feet from Zoe Trocious to get through that pack. She very quickly chewed up three blockers. We line them up here. We got clearly dangerous for the crossers and Jan Trainor, real name for the Manic Attackers.
What is real anyway? What's real is that Jan Trainor just got to jammer. Clearly Danger still trying to find a path on the outside, being held down by Ricky Rupert.
14, making a dramatic attack. Jan Kapow wearing the star for the double crossers. Mia Goham once again for the dramatic attackers. The jam has begun slowly. Now it's picking up a little bit of pace. The scrum gets to going. Yom Kippur with a little bit ahead of steam, takes a shot, oh, Mia Goham.
Bashimus was an absolutely perfectly timed takeout on Yom Kippur there. She was one step of daylight, and Bashimus shut the door hard.
Both teams trying to get past their opponent's walls. Joe Guzman bridging the gap between the two, and then it just devolves into chaos. Mia Goham finds a way around on the inside and on the outside. And Joe Guzman knocks her out, pulls her back, so Mia calls off the jam.
Mia gets all five and decides she doesn't want to go through that again. Like that, they can afford to take those call-offs. Currently 81-14 favored the Manics, with only about 12 minutes gone in the game.
Right now, Bort, for number 75, the jammer for the Manic Attackers, and Sugar Rush, jammer for the Double Crossers. Clearly dangerous with a nice shot on Bork.
So Danny tried to recycle on Bork, but Claire was the top target. Now Claire does it again, bringing Bork back, but now Claire goes to the box. So Bork has some room to play. Meanwhile, Sugar Rush trying to deal with Claudia damage, methamphetamine, Budapest, and the jammer again. Bork. The Manic Attackers' 10th lead jam call in a row.
Sugar Rush able to escape the pack. As 444 calls off the jam. They got three for the Manic Attackers.
Indeed, Mumble. So on paper, the Manics coming into this one as the favorite. Even though both teams have not won a game yet this season, the Manics are the only team to actually give the Hell Spells in this game. The Crossers lost the Bells by 208 points. Just earlier tonight, we saw the Fury lose the Bells by 125 points. Last month, the Manics lost by 1 point. Just that one, that was a classic for the ages.
Right now, it looks like we're going to have an official timeout. I'm about to take a look at the best in the box. DJ Danger from Mode Events is keeping us moving tonight. They got events and personalized DJ services, creating perfect moments, one song at a time. Mode Events. DJ Danger will be at the Waterhouse in Lakeview this evening. If you want to continue dancing.
Josie currently the only jammer to take lead for the double crossers in this game. And does it again, the jammer, Joseph Belsonardis with the double crossers, but just one step behind Zoe Trocious. Zoe trips up trying to go around Josie.
She got up so quickly. To learn and to learn, I mean, you're gonna fall down, but it's about how fast you get back up. And Zoe certainly got on quickly there.
Very true. Of course, the 0-0 call.
One blocker on the box right now, and 84-14 in favor. Jan Trainer is your lead jammer, doing what she does. Yao Kapow keeping some pressure on her. Watch that pack form. Jan Trainer's going to hit it.
Trainer thought about jumping the apex, decided to keep her heels in the ground, and turns away with it with one point.
If you engage another skater while mid-air, it's off on a penalty. A kamikaze block, you don't want to do that. That can get you kicked out of a game.
Like in her first banner of the night, Malicious from the double crossers. That's both Zelina and Savage all over Malicious. However, Diego Hand not having easy time herself. Dealing with Charles Sabaton in the front of the mat there, ice board off the box. But Mia eventually gets out with lead jammer status. Malicious nailed in between turns one and two.
Courtesy of Zelina. Manic defense not letting Malicious make any ground. Meanwhile, Mia Gohan finds her way around the outside.
It's like
Cuban Miss L headed to the box and they destroy the back penalty.
Mia Gohan adds a few more points around the outside there. It's going to be four more for Mia. And that's going to be a 9-0-0. Works for 9-0, timeout, double crossings.
We'd like to thank our sponsor, ATI Physical Therapy, the official sports medicine provider of the Windy City Rollers. Choose ATI for your physical therapy and sports medicine needs. ATI Physical Therapy. We'd like to thank the Lumbar Roller Rink. They supply the Player of the Game Award, specializing in birthday party events, adult and kid lessons, and of course they sell skates.
LumbarRumbering.com.
You watch this tonight, you say, I want to do that, you can do that. If you want to play for Windy City, you can go to tryout at WindyCityRollers.com. If you're a junior, you can skate with the second slip slaughter. They have a table up at section 107. And if you're a man, you can skate with the Blues Brothers.
A variable plethora of options.
Yes. There are other options around Chicago as well.
Equally variable.
We don't promote that. Three to four in the back favoring the double crossers as Cuban Missile is in the box. However, lead camera goes to 1-4-4.
Josie Simone is out behind 4-4-4 trying to pick up some points. A penalty being called. It looks like 4-4-4 getting to the box on a back block penalty.
So she loses lead jammer status, and now Josie Simonis will have the rest of this jam to try and get some points on the board for the crossers.
Cutting the track penalty being called on Cuban Missile.
Second penalty in two jams for Cuban Missile. Now Josie in a good position here. We already have 10 and plenty of time here. There's still over a minute left in the jam. Goes around the outside. And with that pass, has just gone over the crossers total of the game so far. 15 points right now.
Ferocious screen from Danny Get Your Guns to give Josie Simonis a pass on the outside that time. Pat is back in motion. No pack being called as the teams get away from each other. And Kelly Guindavalli headed to the box on an out-of-play engagement penalty for engaging during the out-of-play.
The managed log track of where the crossers were and were blocking a good 15 feet ahead of the rest of the players. Only Kelly Cavalli goes to the box on that one though. Bork continues her scoring after returning to the penalty box.
But she did hold back Josie Simonis quite a while, but she picks up 4 points on that pass. Bork goes back to the box. Makes her pass, picks up 4 points.
and destroying the path called on human missile. 32 jams.
Wow, that's fantastic. Bork went back to the box and another back box to do it again. So a cavalcade of families there in a minute is going to give Clarity Dangerous a chance to build on what Joseph Cronus just did there.
For Clearly Dangerous and the Double Crossers here. We'll see if they can build a little momentum. 11.5 minutes left in the first half. Claire! Marlene Scherer finds her way around Gaff's bump to the inside. On the scoring pass, Clearly Danger hits the pack. Gaff's bump, number 5x5, holding her off.
Bethany making her way to the inside of the track to hold down some defense. Good recycling going on at the front. Courtesy of Gaff's run body coming down from Bethany. And the Mannix box empties. Bork makes her way out and Claire Lee's interest falls off the jam after Claire picks up a full five. So that's possibly a pretty significant production now, only about a half ahead. Josie on that last jam, but 28, well, that last jam, but she can't go 28 points double the cross score for that one. Well, last two games, really good hands on the crossers, but it is, and they keep it going, and she'll be resting this half.
Jam Trainer and Yon Kapow going at it, and it looks like an out of play being called on Matt Savage. Lead jammer going to Yon Kapow. Let's see what the double crossers can do with lead jammer status. Samantha Judge doing a nice job holding off Jam Trainer, giving Yon Kapow some time. Yon Kapow can call it off before Jam can catch the pass.
Those are some beautiful screens by the crossers right there. I'm not sure if they set that one up, but Yon Kapow had a huge lane on the outside of her score, and every advantage was blocked by a different crosser on that one.
Mia
going at it,
Jones Simone, Joe Jam, this time around. Both recently selected to our travel game to get the other hand. Looks like Lee Jammer going to Mia Goham. Forearm penalty being called. Looks like that one will be going to Bell.
Mia sails over the apex, takes 4 points, and calls it before Josie is able to get that score. No, that's the first game the Mannix won since the crossover timeout.
Occupy the pivot line. And the double crossers move forward. That amphetamine, the lone blocker for the Mannix attackers.
Matt Savage rolls back in to join her, but not before Clarity Dangerous picks up a lead jammer status.
Stretches Bork contending with a pretty strong wall. Max Savage now the lone blocker for the Mannix attackers.
Yeah, Bork trying to get around spell sabotage and Samantha Judge as Clearly Dangerous comes around trying to score some more points for the crossers who sorely need them. Hope unable to stop Claire. Max Savage comes up into the business, now hook back up there. And Claire is through. 10 points. Jam for the double crossers, who are showing some signs of life here after a very, very short opening.
We've got 7 minutes 20 seconds left in the period, 61-111 in favor of the Mannix attackers. Yon Kapow taking on Zoe Trocious at the line.
Oh.
Both teams are down one blocker to the penalty box. Jane.
Zoe, my apologies. Shaking off into the face, looks like, but as the jammer and is trucking for points here. Claudia being damaged off the box as Manic blocked Zoe through untouched. And now Yama's finally out, but Zoe already has five and has a pretty light pack here to contend with. Oh, guess is wrong and ends up running into the back of Mary Top and Caps, I believe that is.
No points scored for that jam. And this time around, we're looking at Joey Simonis and Jam Training as a nostalgia jam. If you're nostalgic for the first jam of the game,
were we ever so young?
Are the reunions ever as good as the original? We're about to find out. 61-116 in favor of the Mannix with under 6 minutes to go. Lee Jenner going to Jan Trainer. Jody Simonis keeping her on her heels. Oh, wheels.
Nicely timed spin from Jan is going to allow her three points for Jan Trainer.
Clearly dangerous. Up against Mia Gohan this time around. One blocker apiece. Each team in penalty box. Multiplayer block being assessed. Looks like that one's going to Dashbot. Clearly dangerous is your lead jammer as Mia Gohan getting the hell up in the back.
Player is going to call with four. That will keep blocker Dash Spunk in the box. So the Chalk will start this next jam with a 4-3 pack advantage. And have just added four more points to their score, courtesy of Clarity Dangerous.
4.5 minutes left in the half, 65-119 in favor of the Manic Attackers. Double Cross has been storming back. Jam Trainer going up against Yom Kapow at the jam line.
Nice hop, skip, and jump from Jam Trainer to jump back and bounce quickly after being knocked out by Fellow Sabotage. And she's going to parlay that into lead jammer status. Meanwhile, Matt Savage and Yom Kapow come back, and Matt gets the hit from behind. That's how you block the back of the pack. Yom Kapow was unable to sneak in behind Mac. And Mac just put a few more inches on that recycle. Hence, up a cycling from that right there. Yom to the box, and it's now Jam Trainer all by her lonesome, putting up more points than Mac Dapper.
Jam Trainer, another scoring pass here, weaving her way through. Now she meets the wall. One blocker beats Stella Sabotage, able to get five points. Mac Attackers. Eisen Burr and Beth Amphetamine both head to the box.
Oh, Jan Trainer takes a hit as she gets around. Samantha Judge stays on her feet and puts up five more. Here comes Yom Kapow back to the penalty box, currently not on a scoring pass after being forced to the box during the opening pass.
Jan tried the spin apex jump. She got taken out by Samantha Judge. She will get recycled back. And he does Yom Kapow.
Still plenty of time in this jam, though. 35 seconds. Yom is out. Jan Trainor has all the time in the world to finish off this scoring pass, though. Let's see if she can get all her points. And she'll kill the jam there with only two more.
2 minutes and 25 seconds left in the half. 65-141 in favor of the Mannix. And we have Josie Simonis and Dean Gohan jamming for their teams.
Mannix lead is almost back to its largest on the game. It peaked at 80 points and is currently standing at 76.
Mia Gohan with a vertical speed on the inside. She is your lead jammer, but Josie Elsimolis is going to keep some pressure on. Watch that pack reform. Manic Attackers trying to isolate on Sugar Rush. Whistles in that jam. See, what did Mia get? She got 3 points for Mia Gohan.
Okay, well, that's good. Apex is just enough to get enough space for those 3 points. Before Josie will come in and take her own.
One blocker down currently for the Double Crossers as the scrum begins. Zoe taking shots, turning different directions, but she kept on going, and now she is leading Jammer Zoe Trocious.
Natalie Bonds emptying out as the Double Crossers return to full sprint. Clearly dangerous, out on her scoring pass. Jam gets called off by Zoe Trocious before the cross can take up any points. So it's looking like that's 3 more points out the board for the Mannix.
We've got time for one more jam in the first half. We're going to get a look at Budapest for the first time, jamming for the Mannix Attackers. Against Yom Kapow for the Double Crossers. Going early on. Yom Kapow finds a room on the inside. She's your lead jammer for the Silent Assassins in black.
Budapest up in her first jam action, I believe, as a Mannix at all, definitely tonight, is trying to get around Sugar Rush and Mary Poppercaps. Yom Kapow trying to hop around Dime Trinor. Dime Trinor says, nope, and recycles into the back along with Liga and Medina. Budapest is through to cheers from the Mannix bench.
But Sheemit with a nice shot there, slowing down Yom Kapow. I hear a whistle. Shrek cut off by Sheemit. Budapest scores, I do believe. Yes, indeed, 4 points.
And now Trainor and Gulita, only two on the track, but are working over Yom Kapow and are able, I believe, to equalize that one. We are at the game. What about it? 6-8 for the Double Crossers, 151 for the Mannix Attackers.